There are some criminals in this world who become popular for their charisma, intense lifestyle, smart tactics, and carefully planned heists. There lived a man in the United States in the 30s who could perhaps be called the original gangster, and was almost regarded as a national celebrity. This man, John Dillinger, is the most infamous bank robber in the US, who committed a series of bank robberies with theatrical flair, and proved to the authorities that no prison was hard for him to escape. Born in 1903, Dillinger showed supreme leading ability from boyhood. He was a mischievous boy who led a neighborhood gang named the Dirty Dozen, which would go around pulling lighthearted pranks on the neighbors. In 1924, a friend proposed to rob a grocery store for some quick money, to which Dillinger agreed. However, the plan failed, and his friend fled the scene, leaving him behind. Dillinger was caught and sentenced to serve at least 10 years in prison, where he met and befriended a couple of experienced bank robbers such as Pippant and Van Meter. In 1933, he was granted parole to visit his dying stepmother. Pippant and Van Meter asked for his assistance in escaping prison upon his leave, and Dillinger devised a smart plan to free his friends from prison. They all fled to Chicago, and there, Dillinger formed a gang with his escaped friends and some other experienced criminals. The gang robbed 10 banks in 4 Midwestern states over the course of a year. The media also showed great interest in the Dillinger gang, and Americans eagerly followed his antics via newspapers. In December 1933, one of the gang's robberies did not proceed as planned, and Dillinger allegedly shot an officer during their escape. The gang messed this heist up badly, and the police managed to catch them. Dillinger was placed in Crown Point Prison, a facility that was deemed impossible to escape, but not for him. Legend has it that he carved a wooden gun, dyed it with black shoe polish, and used it to force his way out of the prison. He stole a police car and drove back to Chicago. Now that he'd crossed state lines with a stolen car, he'd committed a federal crime, and the FBI launched its own manhunt on Dillinger. Upon his return to Chicago, he quickly recruited new members for his gang, most notably Lester Gillis, or Babyface Nelson, and they relocated to St. Paul, Minnesota. The new gang continued robbing banks and occasionally murdering people for another year, but the FBI were hot on their trail, and they were forced to retreat to a lodge in Wisconsin. The owner recognized Dillinger and quickly informed the FBI. In the following shootout, an FBI agent and a civilian were killed, and several more were wounded. Dillinger barely managed to escape the entrapment, but next time, he wasn't going to be so lucky. John Dillinger was labeled as America's public enemy number one and placed a $10,000 reward on his head. In the meantime, he had become romantically involved with a brothel owner named Anna Sage. She tipped the FBI agents off that she and Dillinger would be going on a date to see a movie in a theater. The agents surrounded the couple as they were leaving, and Dillinger dashed off towards Alley. However, his luck had run out, and he was shot to death before making his escape. Despite his notorious crimes, he became a very popular figure in pop culture. His life story has been retold in several movies, the most notable of which being Public Enemies by Michael Mann, which starred Johnny Depp as Dillinger.